Loc, nice of you to join us. You played this deck in a tournament. What was this for?
This was a Facebook tournament series called JGB Tournaments. It's a Facebook group on that's just been holding tournaments ever since Poke Beach tournaments ended.
Okay. And you've had quite a bit of success IRL with this deck too, right?
Well, the season kind of ended pretty prematurely, so I haven't had the success I wanted just because there was a lack of events. But
I see. Well, I'm looking forward to getting this special edition of the N to One for Game. We got a kind of a collab here. We'll definitely put your details in the video description, and we'll definitely shout them off at the end of the video.
Mm-hmm.
Other than that, anything else to say before we get started?
No, I think we're good. All right. So I'm playing Mew3 Malamar, and I already played my opponent in Swiss rounds in round 5, and he's playing Spell Tag Malamar. So right off the bat, I already knew it was a terrible matchup for me. So
I have had trouble with Spell Tag Malamar. I know how you feel.
Yep. All right. So I was starting hand. This was actually not that bad because the two Pokemon I needed, I just started out with just straight on the bench with Absol and Ndidi.
Now, Ndidi isn't your main attacker, though, so why didn't you attach to Mew Mew?
Oh, because I'm weak to Psychic, so I'm trying to limit every access they have to just free prizes.
I see.
And
how big was this tournament?
There was like 74 players, so it was 7 Swiss rounds.
Okay.
And we were both 4-0 during Swiss when we met up in round 5.
And your opponent's quite lucky there, got a professor's research. Mm-hmm. You know, you probably do want to go first with any Malamar deck, regardless of the supporter rule.
Right, just because it's an evolution deck, so it's my preference to go first. I know a couple other Malamar players that actually want to go second, just because they get the additional supporter, so it's easier to set up. And I know my opponent is playing Triple Viridian. Or it might be double, but Viridian will definitely help me out, so I'm okay just letting him have the same for now.
I hear ya.
Yep.
Oh, and here we go. I'm betting that a second Inkay is coming down.
Mm-hmm. I was kind of surprised that he put the skateboard on the active, on the benched one instead of the active, because then you just had a free Subtle Wish without needing a switch card right away. So,
oh yeah, I mean, if it's my first turn, I would want to do 2 Stellar Wishes if I could.
Mm-hmm. I got a pretty good top deck. Just grabbing an extra NK off on the board. So,
In DDV, that's going to one hit KO the opponent's Giratina, no matter what, right?
Right. It does 60 for every energy on it. And plus an extra 10 base. So so pretty much all I want to do is just hit for, I guess, 190. And since I already evolved a Malamar, I don't want to give up a free Malamar, so that's why I just let him sack an Inke if need be.
Oh, sure.
Because unfortunately, it does like zero damage to a Jirachi, so.
Yeah, and we'll see if this Absol keeps their Jirachi in play.
Mm-hmm.
You know, in keeps it in the active, because an escape board's not going to help.
Right. I know that's one issue with the basic spell tag Malamar, is that you just have the four switches, and you just have to attach energy to your Jirachi just to get just to retreat with your Jirachi and the skateboard. I think I also would just attach the spell tag to the Malamar anyway, just in case.
Sure.
Instead of just stitching it there.
And here we go. Looks like Giratina is about to draw some first blood. They get the first prize. I definitely want to see how you come back from this. Now you only got to do 90 damage to it.
Yeah. Well, since the Viridian was already in play, I just immediately knew I wanted to attach to Ndidi. So, and if you actually play the spell tag mirror. Malamar is actually one of the best attackers in the spell tag Malamar matchup. So you could just do extra damage. You could do 60 damage when your opponent is trying to do either 40 damage with baby blams or 3 damage with baby Mew. Because the problem with attacking with Giratina is that you're putting 4 damage on your board somewhere. And I got a pretty lucky top deck, so, or prize card, so.
I'll say.
I was kind of struggling here if I didn't get anything, so.
Yeah, you just chucked a Mewtwo. I'd say that's pretty desperate.
Yep. So one thing I did notice was that they're like GX attackers, they're all gone. So pretty much they're just relying on using 2 energy attacks each turn. So that's one bad thing, is that this Mimikyu could one-shot me back.
Ouch.
So I'm on my baby Blounce turn, and I just top decked it right off the bat. So all I'm really looking for right now is just to find a way to retreat, and luckily I did find it with the air balloon, which is, that's the main reason I did not put up the the Malamar, just because I needed something that could retreat for like one instead. So
there you go, the main star of the show, Trevenant, mm-hmm. who fortunately is not weak to psychic.
Yep.
Ooh. I love to see how the math works out on this.
Well, I still wanted to get rid of their attacker, just because they'd have to set up another two prize attacker, but I did not want to get down to their baby blown turn. So, sure. Just knocking out the active and doing some damage was okay. Because now they have to set up another baby Mimikyu. Because sure. They only have one Malamar out.
And Blacephalon is not weak to psychic. It's weak to dark.
Mm-hmm. But even if they copycat, they're just copycatting a fireworks bomb just to do 4 damage anywhere, because I'm not at 3 prizes yet.
Oh, that's right. Yep. And the only one Malamar in play, so looks like we're not getting an attack from Giratina this turn.
Mm-hmm. Now, this is actually a little bit of a mistake by them, is that they should not even attach that psychic to the Giratina yet.
Why?
You'll probably see it in a couple minutes, but they could actually knock out my Malamar with one distortion door here and a baby Mew here. So then they'd be at 2 prizes instead. So now they're just getting energy to attach manually to Baby Mew, when you could attach it to the Jirachi and then retreat with an energy on it and not psychic recharge the Giratina. And seeing that they did not have a switch, play a switch immediately, I'm pretty sure they whiffed the, I think they're like, it probably would be their third or fourth switch. So.
Oh, man, talk about a good game. You get to do 2 fireworks bombs in a game. I would love to be able to do that.
Mm-hmm.
There we go. Going to get set up just a little bit more.
Yep.
There we go. Marnie. One of the best disruption cards. And you're going to have to explain to me, what the heck is that super scoop up in there for?
Oh, you know, I just count it as a half of a switch. And then, at worst, it heals as well. So the play I would have done was just scoop up the Malamar if I found the extra energy. Or if I flipped heads on scoop up. So, this is a double knockout.
And you just drew two prizes on purpose so that they couldn't fireworks bomb you.
Right.
Well, I was wondering how you'd catch up, and here you go. So you Marnied your opponent a few turns earlier. Mm-hmm. They missed the second Inkay on the bench to turn into a Malamar, and now they're really suffering from only having one Malamar available.
Yep, that's one of the good things about the Mew3 Malamar, is that you're playing quad Marnie. Just because Marnie into Night Watch is just a pretty good combo. If you'd seen the expanded or Ace Trainer, Night Watch just wins tons of games. This is a close version to that for standard. So,
so here we go. Are they going to get that Jirachi out of the active position? I am just dying to see. There we go.
Mm-hmm.
And that ties the game.
So it's pretty obvious what I'm trying to attack with, so.
Yeah. Got an easy game from here on out.
Mm-hmm.
You've got a 3-card hand. You limit their resources with Night Watch.
And the card I was looking for, which is why I used Denny instead of research, was just so I could find a Marnie in case I wanted to play the Marnie instead.
I agree.
And I also just benched a Gengar just in case they somehow top deck a Cynthia or research or something.
Nice. And here we go. It looks like your opponent's got limited options here for drawing a prize next turn. Mm-hmm. I don't know what they would do. I don't know, maybe if they distortion door your benched Malamar 3 times somehow.
I think they just knew they couldn't knock out anything, and they couldn't even use the grid catcher just because they'd have a zero.
You didn't bench that Mew Mew.
So, actually, in Swiss, he did 2-0 me pretty quickly, though, so now that I kind of learned the matchup a lot better, so I'm just playing a little bit better. And unfortunately, I did have to start a Mewtwo Mew-GX. But I did have a quick ball in my hand, so. And I got pretty lucky again with my top deck and Mulligans being a Gengar and a treasure, so I could get rid of the Stinger, which is just this was actually a pretty tough choice. Usually I take the guarantee. Usually, I like finding a guaranteed Silvally, but since they started NK as well, they can't just attach an energy to NK and then retreat into Malamar. or retreating to Jirachi. So I took the guaranteed.
You get an extra turn out of this.
Mm-hmm.
Yep, and the only way to get out of this Absol lock is to, you know, play Switch. And even if they get a Switch to, you know, get that active out of, you know, the active position, they still have to use up a Switch, you know, and that Switch could have, you know, gone towards something else later game.
Mm-hmm.
So it, as far as I'm concerned, if you're forcing your opponent to burn up their resources, you're winning.
Yep. And I see that they treasured away a Malamar, so their hand must be either really good or they already have a Malamar in their hand. Yep. So immediately I already see that they just have a two card hand. So I don't mind getting just a guaranteed knockout, but I'm just checking what's what I should grab with the shared roll. But the reason why I played the shared roll for Mimu is just because I could just put it on the bench or put it on the bottom of my deck. And immediately I just want to grab some additional attackers.
Nice. Wow, you've got a lot of attacks available to you. Mm-hmm. Those discards really add up. And you got rid of his Inke. Wow.
Yep.
that really puts him in a bind. Now he can't charge up anything. He's got to wait at least another turn.
I only needed one item for to knock out with Poltergeist, but I figured I'd just take the safe play and just get the Brave Buddies on Savali.
Sure. Wow, this opponent just, wow, they've got the whole line of psychic single prize attackers. We've mm-hmm. seen Unbroken Bonds Mew, we've seen the Giratina, obviously, and now they've got Esper on the bench.
Yep, but I'd rather see an Esper here than another AK, so.
I agree.
And they learned from last time and just attach an energy to their Jirachi instead. I wasn't really sure who I wanted to balloon, but I think all my attacks required like two energy or me using Marnie. So what I went for is just trying to find a way to get the other Naga, the sniping Naga, with two energies on it. One from just one from Ndidi, or one from Malamar, one for my Mayo attachment. But since I whiffed like a treasure, I just had to use one of my two energy attacks. And Brave Buddies only does 120. So I just went for the Poltergeist play, and I hit zero.
Wow, I can't recall the last time I've ever gotten zero on a Poltergeist.
And immediately, I see that they just top decked the quick ball, too. So.
Talk about bad timing.
Mm-hmm.
And if this Mimikyu poltergeist you, that would be bad news with four trainers in your hand.
Mm-hmm. So I really didn't need this last bench spot anymore, so I just wanted to ditch with Quick Ball. And the thing was, I didn't need Ditto anymore, just because
because you got rid of the Soul Valley GX.
Yep, and I didn't want like it to get spell tagged or Tina pinged. I still wanted my Bucephalon in the deck, which is why I discarded it there. No. That's why I just whiffed the treasure. I also could have Viridian Force for another energy into my discard, but I just wanted to be play safe again. Mm. So this time I only get two attackers or two trainer cards with Poltergeist, but it's a at least better than zero like last time.
Yeah. Ooh, there we go. Yeah, I was afraid of the Great Catcher when you put down the Dedenne.
I think I was fine. Just because if they somehow retreat and Portuguese me back, then they're only doing 100. And this actually kind of helps me because now I just attach an energy to Dedenne and use second recharge to get fourth energy onto Mewtwo and Mew-GX. And that way, I could do a 170 snipe somewhere.
Oh, that would be fun. So they've still got this Giratina stuck in the active spot, and they're mm-hmm. just recharging other stuff.
Yep.
If that Mew comes down, that'll be a sweet target for a baby Blacephalon, you know, in situations where you can use baby Blacephalon.
Mm-hmm.
But it's a bummer if you're trying to Venom Shot.
Yep. So I see another pass. So this is where I just go with the play I just told you about, where I just attach and retreat. I still wanted to set up a second attacker, and I wanted to find a Marnie for a future turn, which is why I just played research there just to find a supporter a Marnie next turn though. And the choice I had to decide was between Mimikyu and Esper or Malamar, and I would have done Malamar. I think going with the Mimikyu was fine, just because they already had the two energies on it anyway, so.
Hey, I want to point out, you forgot to actually use Lavender Town last turn.
Oh, yeah.
we'll put a meter at the bottom of this video, how many times you don't use it. I'm just kidding, Loc. I wouldn't do that to you.
See, usually I just remember to use it when I'm using like Nightwatch.
Poltergeist. Yeah, Nightwatch.
Nightwatch and Poltergeist. I just new. I don't want my opponent to have Viridian Forest anymore. So let me just bounce it with any type of stadium. And one thing about this matchup was that my Trevenant was prized, which is why I had to. Is why I just focused on attacking with the Mewtwo. All right, so
close.
Immediately, I already see that my opponent has like four cards left in deck. So pretty much, I'm just hoping for a scoop up heads just to heal my. And in my hand, I'm looking for two things. I'm checking if I have a Marnie in my deck, and I'm also checking if I have the second scoop up in my deck, so that way I don't mind making a risky play here and trying to heal the Mewtwo and Mew with whatever possible method I can.
And I'm glad you healed that Mew with Ndidi, because one distortion door would have killed the Mew Mew.
Mm-hmm. So this time I do get the heads, and pretty much they're going to be stuck at six prizes now.
Nice.
Yep.
And you didn't put the Mew Mew back down as a backup attacker, but you're still good because you can still put down any attacker next turn, do two psychic recharges, and attach from hand, and attack with anything.
Right.
Maybe you'll draw Trevenant out of this prize and get some Night Watch action going on here.
Yep. And just with reset stamp in hand, I'm hoping I get the Trevenant so I can just start attacking. So my opponent is on Baby Blown turn, but not like too worried, just because they're pretty much only knocking out one thing total, so
right.
And one thing to note is that my opponent is at two cards left in deck, while I'm at three cards left in deck. So, and I already saw that they put the Latios in the prizes, or in the discard previously, and I'm pretty sure they also discarded their Solgaleo Lunala. But when I checked this hand here, or their discard this time, I see that they have four Cynthia's in their discard, so they don't have any more shuffle outs. So if I could just survive like three turns, which is pretty easy with their board setup, I could just win by deck out instead. And as long as I don't play the Marnie or the research or the reset stamp, then I would just win by deck out instead.
Exactly. Wow. Well, it looks like you 2-0'd them. If I was you, I'd be scared seeing single prize psychic attackers, you know, But wow, you took that on with confidence. Any other notes to look at before we go into the next match?
No, luckily the Absol and the DD were not prized either game, so I just tried to focus on getting them out like as soon as possible, relatively to set up my own attackers, so that's why I chose just getting one Absol out and one NK out, just so I could set my own attackers.
Okay, then why don't we move into the top four match?
Alright, so this time I did not know what my opponent was playing. So I got heads and I went first just because against a random matchup, I generally just want to go first.
Right.
And I think I have like an okay hand to start, so just because I have outs to like a six card to Dene, so and that right there was actually a pretty bad mulligan because I wanted to keep my great catcher for like turn two just so I could do a like a some type of great catcher play with either their Raichu or their Pikarom. So I think I actually made a mistake here and just discarding it just because I think it was a better play just to keep it in hand. And I think I also probably should have gotten my Absol out, but most Pikaroms are playing Zerora, so it's not that important in the matchup, but I think seeing that they started the Dene, they could find a switch to get their setup.
Sure. Yeah, I mean, if I was playing Pikaram, I would not be scared of Absol, unless the Zeraora was prized.
Mm-hmm. And
DDV is a 180 HP. That's going to be real inconvenient math if they get an Electro Power and a Full Blitz.
Yep. Seeing that they started the Dene, I figured it'd be a tough out to getting a turn one Full Blitz anyway.
Sure, I agree.
But now that I kind of see that their hand, they actually had a pretty busted hand, so.
Wow, yeah, that turn one custom catcher, I was about to say, that hurts until they got the professor's research.
So this is when I immediately start regretting not having the Absol out.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, because they've got the escape board. Yeah, mm-hmm. They're not putting lightning energy on a Jirachi.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, and they don't even have the Zeraora out yet.
Yep. And the research hand was pretty busted because they got two quick balls or a quick ball for Dedenne that they didn't prize and a Coco in their research.
And I love it when my Coco and my Thunder Mountain are not prized and it's turn one.
Mm-hmm.
And An Oranguru. Okay. I have not tested this deck with a Oranguru.
Pretty much a lot of decks that play for research, if you can fit an Oranguru in, you probably should.
And hey, what did I just get done saying? 180. Perfect math.
Yep.
I was thinking that Dedenne start was going to be a problem for them, but apparently not. Busted hand. I'm thinking you're about to get some Malamar and some Marnie action going on here.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, unfortunately, I did not get any backup attackers. So I'm pretty stuck here, so that's why I'm gonna I kinda just lost the game right here, so because now I'm giving up 3 prizes already, so
is there ever a point against Pikaram where you get to Pale Moon GX them and win the game? Like in general.
Probably not. Horror House is probably the better GX attack in this matchup, just because you could just if you have 2 energy on yourself, you could give them a 7 card hand, and then you just do Poltergeist while they have like a 8 card hand or whatever.
That makes sense. All right, so they've got a 3 prize lead here.
Mm-hmm.
And you're going to try to make the best of it.
Yep. I want to say it's unwinnable, but it's pretty close to unwinnable here. Just because they did not even use their GX attack either. So I have to avoid getting one shot by a like Raichu Electro Power.
Ooh, that would hurt. And I'm seeing this video, you know, this is sight unseen for me.
Mm-hmm.
Is this best 2 out of 3 timed?
No, it's not.
Oh, okay, good. Because I was just thinking, you know, if you think you're gonna lose, you just you think you're gonna lose game one, you just quit and then go to game 2 or 3 and give yourself some more time. But if it's untimed, mm-hmm. I can see why you're still playing this out.
Yep.
And there they have it.
Yep. I could have used the Denny on my end, but I was actually kind of worried about Tag Bolt GX as well. So that's why I did rebench the Denny for a new card, new set of hands. But knowing that they're Pikaram, I do want to go second if I win the coin flip. So, and you get to actually pick what you want to go for game 2. So, immediately I just pick second.
All right.
Uh, And unfortunately, this hand is not that good, so. So
there,
usually
a Lavender Town. I'll see how many times you actually get to use it.
Yeah, so I kind of don't want to give my opponent three and fours either, just because it just makes the turn two full blitz for them that much easier for them. So just by discarding an energy with Viridian Forest, getting a new one, and then using Coco, it just less pieces to give them. So
right. Ooh, hey, there's something we didn't see last game. Tapu Koko V.
Mm-hmm.
Can swing for an incredible 200, but only yields two prizes.
Yep. It's definitely a good inclusion for the deck.
Wish there was some way you could just get, like, three extra damage counters on it somehow, and then Venom Shot it while it's on the bench. That would be really nice. And it would still only be two prizes, though.
Mm-hmm. And my top deck wasn't good either, so I just played the Lavender Town just to check what they have.
Busted.
And I'm kind of sort of...
Oh, a coin flip. Oh, do you get it?
And I looked at that. I flipped that, so. or they flipped tails, so.
Oh, man.
Otherwise, it was going to be a really, really short game.
You know, I've seen it before. I've seen it. A game hinges. It hinges on a sleep flip.
Mm-hmm. All right. And seeing that they got the Lysander Labs with their stadium nav, I just know Thunder Mountain surprised this game, so.
Oh, right.
It just gives me some out to hopefully being luckier.
Oh, man, are they going to tinkle your turn?
So now I gotta survive another turn here.
Do they whiff the switch? Whiff. No switches.
But I did see that they went for the peek around with quick ball. So seems to me like they probably whiffed it. Just because if you just had the switch, you would have just played it outright. And I got a pass again, so.
Wow, you can't even evolve to Malamar because you lose your hypnosis.
Mm-hmm. So I'm just checking their hand. They don't have any type of switch out, so.
Oh, you're thinking about... Oh, you do evolve.
Yep. So I don't think they have an out to the turn one. To a full blitz, so sure. I think it just makes more sense for me to great catcher.
That's what I would have done.
And since they had an electro power in hand, I just knew that they could just knock out Woof of the Denny if they flipped heads. So I felt evolving was a better play here, just because. Now they need two electro powers to knock out the Malamar.
Yeah, and I'm pretty sure they burned one up already.
Yep. Because they burnt it up last time trying to get the NK out.
And a Jirachi. Let's see how long this Jirachi gets stuck in the active.
So I kind of knew that they were going to have to do plays like Custom Catcher for a card, so that's why I kind of wanted to evolve the Malamar just so they had less outs of knocking me out with the Dene.
Right.
But since they already retreated manually with Alolan Raichu into Jirachi, they'd have to get a switch here to start attacking. And I kind of missed what they got, but they went for the skateboard instead. So. Ooh, and I finally got out of it. So.
Where's that Dedenne? Oh my gosh. And your opponent comments, "Woo, yeah. That was close." Ooh, so much better. Now we can actually start playing the game.
Like, I'm pretty sure if I actually just went for the. Actually, I think I made a mistake there. I don't think I should have put the air balloon on the Malamar. Just because now the energy is stuck on Malamar. And it's just making it harder to retreat into everything.
Right.
But my hand's so bad right now is that I might as well just go for let him knock it out at the Dene.
Yeah. Shouldn't you send out Absol since that's only one prize?
I think I was like in such a rough shape that I just have to give up the two prizes. Yeah. But I know what my opponent's trying to do is trying to just knock it out with the Alolan Raichu. And then I could probably just do a Pale Moon GX back to the Alolan Raichu just to get energies off the board. And just try to win by them running out of energy.
Sure, yeah. I mean, you're supposed to, you know, get a full blitz early game, and you're just supposed to be on easy street from there on out because you've got a whole bunch of energy. Mm-hmm. But if the full blitz doesn't happen and they've got to find other ways to get the energy and then you get rid of the energy, yeah, it's hard for them. What do they got? And full 160. Yeah, and a successful Pale Moon GX should do the trick. Just need to attach 3 energy. Mew Mew's good since you're not weak to Psychic this time. I'm sorry, you are weak to Psychic, but you're not going up against Psychic this time.
And this is one of the mistakes from last time. Like, if I just put this air balloon on the other Inkay, I would have had a second recharge last turn, plus a second recharge this turn as well.
Yeah, because you get to reach to retreat the Malamar to get energy in the discard pile.
Right. And this is actually a kind of a mistake as well. I kind of need... Indeedy is actually pretty good in the matchup. Just because all their... Once they do full blitz, they have a ton of energy on themselves. So Indeedy could get one shots on anything that's fully charged up.
Busted.
Yep.
And looks like you got that third energy anyway. Hooray!
And my opponent did not have too many like trainer cards in their like six card hand, so I just have to go with Pale Moon just because it just got rid of energy on, and they already used Cocoa Prism.
Yeah, and we still don't know where that Thunder Mountain Prism Star is.
But I forget if they actually had the energy from last turn or if they just manually attached it here. So I'm just checking my deck for Marnies and research stamps, so, and energy, so. And I see three trainer cards, so. And I'm debating whether or not I want to play this research because I might deck out. So,
yep, you've got a five card deck. Wow, and you still haven't drawn a prize yet.
And I'm just hoping I get rid of research, but they still got it.
So they haven't GX'd yet.
Mm-hmm.
If they tingly return GX you, you've got an out here in a switch.
Right, but I think they're just saving it up
for Lightning Ride.
Yeah. And seeing them using electric power here. Oh. I thought that they might have like an energy switch in hand or something like that. So, seeing that they just attach manually, I kind of just know that they're just going to most likely just going to pass. So, this is actually where I'm kind of making a mistake. I thought I had Naginadel in my discard.
Oh, no.
And... even look at their hand, they only have three items. So I probably should have Lavender Town first, but um
So you are looking for the Venom shot, and you don't see it.
Mm-hmm. So this is where I just checked this card just to double see that I still
make
didn't
sure
have
the
it.
The app isn't glitched.
Mm-hmm.
What do I do?
Yep. And Fortune Guys doesn't help either, so. So I figured I'd just play to Marnie just see what the rest of my deck is. And all right, I know I put back another Marnie. So I could I won't deck out just because eventually I'll just play cards or. I'll play the Marnie just to refill my deck up.
Right. Uh-oh. Volkner. That's never a good sign.
And I just wanted to double check that I did have one more energy in my deck. So, seeing that they had one custom catcher, I kind of knew that they have a second custom catcher in their hand. Just because they're trying to set up a custom catcher on my Mewtwo.
Right.
But then I just checked, and that was their three-card hand. So,
heads.
If I get the heads here, then I actually feel pretty confident that I could win this matchup just because I'll be going down in prize cards first. I'll be getting some prizes first. And. But unfortunately, I did whiff the scoop up, so. Because.
And you got rid of the custom catcher. Thank goodness.
Mm hmm.
And here we were talking earlier about how, you know, they were going to have a hard uphill game because they didn't full blitz and you Pale Moon GX them to get rid of all their energy. And they recovered from it.
Mm-hmm. But I also had to pass like three turns in a row. So I think between those two things, it was a pretty rough sailing for me. So.
At this point, I'm sure some of the folks are going to be saying, hey, maybe you should have Dragonite GX or, you know, Ultra Necrozma to be able to do 270 and knock out the Rai. Is that a worthwhile trade?
To me, I don't think it is, just because I'd rather just focus on my consistency. Just because that's one of the reasons why people just stop playing the deck in general, just because of lack of consistency when you just play ADPZ or Pikaram here.
Ooh,
yeah, so
hard.
Yep. Flipping tails on the scoop up hurt here. Just because one it lets me it just lets me. Well, I already see that they got the.
You're about to deck out.
Yep.
But one final stamp.
Yep. So yeah, if I did get the heads, that's an additional four cards in my hand, and then I could just Marnie myself here and get more cards into the deck. just because there's four extra cards in my deck now.
Right. Hand pass draw. Mm-hmm. Wow. Any lessons learned from that that last match?
It was probably just double checking your attackers at the start of your turn instead of the ending of your turn. And yeah, hopefully not passing three turns in a row.
Oh,
and,
gosh.
And hopefully they flip tails on sleep.
Nice. Any general Malamar tips you want to leave our audience with tonight?
Not really sure yet. I think it's just you just have to go by trial and error. Like trying to either save your great catcher for like the last turn of the game, or using it on the first turn of the game is probably like the best use of great catcher. Just so you could do like some horror house into Portuguese plays, or you could just win a game on because of catching like a Dedenne or whatever.
So what do you think of the PTCGO tournament scene right now? Is it getting serious now that we don't have any real tournaments?
Oh, I've actually seen like a ton of online tournament series pop up. So GGB has been running the Poke Beach tournaments for a few years now. After Poke Beach lost their sponsorship with a TCG player to run the tournaments, GGB just ran it himself on Facebook. So I know it was going to be a well-run tournament, and he actually is running like at least four like single elimination tournaments each weekend, and that's along with like a month long tournament. Then I know PokeStats has their own alternative format TCGO series.
Yeah, that's one with like banned cards or something like that.
Yep, so in Expanded, they banned Trevenor, like Oranguru, Tropical Beach, and I think Dolls as well. And in Standard, they actually banned all tag teams. They banned Baby Giratina, and they banned Baby Blacephalon just because it's the best cards in the game right now. So all the tag teams. So it's they actually did run a tournament, and they actually had like 15 different archetypes in that tournament out of 16 players.
That's highly unlikely, but if that's mm-hmm. what the ban list does, man, I'm rooting for them.
Yeah, I think the only repeat deck was a Vika Vault.
Oh gosh.
And then there's a third Discord run by Gibson Archer Tang, and I think he gets help from like Arlo Neal and like Isaac Maslowski, and they are doing like paid tournaments for like $2 and $5 for like 8-person tournaments, and they're also doing like a month-long tournament as well starting next month. So those are probably the three biggest places to do online tournaments right now, and it has pretty much all types of varieties if whether you want to just play like this basic Standard or Expanded, or if you want to play in like paid versions of it, or if you just want to be creative in your deck building and alternate formats versions of Standard and Expanded. So no matter which what type of player you are, or if you want to play for paid or for free. There's definitely options out there for just to keep you from getting rusty when the tournament does start up in, will it be May or September or like next January or whatever.
Yeah, these are different times for sure, and I'm glad that there are people who are making the best of it, just doing what they can in the time being. Mm-hmm. Where can people contact you?
I do stream on Twitch, but it's pretty rarely. It's my Twitch is just the lock with an underscore in it. I usually post all my deck lists on Twitter, and that's also the lock with a underscore, but it also has a zero instead of an O, just because the account was taken way too long ago.
Sure.
Even though accounts have not been used for like 8 years.
Oh wow. So. Yeah, we'll make sure all that stuff is spelled correctly in the video description, along with your deck list. And I guess since we brought up some of the Facebook groups, they're running PTCGO tournaments. I'll throw that into the video description too.
Yeah, we could. I'll link some of the Discords and the Facebook groups out there for it.
Oh, that sounds great. That sounds great. Well, hey. Thanks for teaching our viewers how to play this deck. Anything else you wanted to add before we sign off?
Nope. I'm not on any team. I don't write for any websites or anything. So.
Even though I tell you should write articles. I know you'd be so good at it, Loc. I would read your articles every day.
Well, currently unsponsored, so I'll pass. On shoutouts.
Unsponsored. Okay. Well, we'll collaborate on that. See who can sponsor you. Because I'll see. You're pimping other people's products on Twitter, I'm sure. We'll figure something out.
Oh yeah.
Well, thanks for joining us, Loc. That's all we got for today. Area dose. Goodbye.
All right, see ya.